see a fun activity. You learn everybody's names because you kind of hear them over and over again.
Yeah.
I did something similar to this one time in activity. And it looks good because we all wanted to be successful at this. But if you get a group that are middle school or high school, that isn't necessarily their goal. Their goal is to make somebody else miss it, or they don't really want to do this. And so you're like, why are you doing this? And because that isn't what their main purpose is. Their main purpose is to maybe make somebody else look bad or something. So I think the one time I did it, maybe two times, and the one time it worked good because most people were motivated. But then the next time I did it with these people who had other agendas, and it was frustrating.
I'll deal with classroom groups, but my hook for them is that, oh, well, Mrs. Smith's class did the whole thing in a minute and a half with
exactly.
No drops.
Exactly.
And so you know.
Or they did 10 beanbags. Yeah. I don't know if we could do 10 beanbags.
Exactly. And once you get them in competition with some other outside group, maybe you can get them working together. But that's where the challenge is. And so then part of the debrief would be, why do you have so much trouble doing that? I think it might have been because Bobby was winging that thing every time in so-and-so's face. You know, and talk about the things that went wrong and the things that went well, and that may be where you say, well, you know, maybe if you just focus on this person, or, you know, maybe we could get it done in half the time, or maybe we could get up to 8 beanbags. And you do have to read your group, and, you know, you're going to have, you know, some kids that are just never going to buy in no matter what. But hopefully you can get most of them to buy in just because it's a fun and simple thing. And if you just set it up as a challenge, and like she said, just set up a competition with some outside group, not within your group, it helps.
Do you give them instructions as you did here, or do you let them figure it out?
Most of the time, I'm gonna let them
focus on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like I said, during the activity, you want to talk as little as possible.
Yeah.
So yeah, you wouldn't let them figure those things out on their own. And after a while, kids do figure out, oh, I really just need to look at this person because every time I look away from them, a beanbag hits me in the face. So, you know, I need to focus on that person. And so yeah, I mean, so you let them figure those things out for themselves. Or, you know, if you don't say anything, all the other kids are going to say, Bobby, stop winging it. We can't catch it over here. And he'll be like, oh, okay, well, the group is telling me now that I need to slow down or be gentle or whatever.
And